Greetings, Eric Bakker, New Zealand naturopath. Thanks for coming back and checking out the video. I often get asked by people about how do I assess my stomach? How do I find out if I've got the correct amount of stomach acid? How can I know if I've got enough and not, you know, not too little? So too little stomach acid we call hypochlorhydria, or not enough. No stomach acid we call achlorhydria, which is a big problem for really older people in particular. I remember in 2003, I went to Seattle and I saw an interesting, I had a conference there, you know, with a whole lot of doctors. I think it was called Nutritional Medicine, Nutritional Therapy in Medical Practice, Dr. Jonathan Wright and Dr. Alan Gavey. Jonathan Wright is an incredible doctor and he actually wrote a whole book on low stomach acid. And he was a very big fan of testing everybody for, you know, gastric function to make sure that the stomach worked properly. If you've got hypochlorhydria or low stomach acid, it's going to really affect your health so bad you've got no idea how bad it can affect you. You need to have a pH in the stomach of around 2 to 4, often around 3.5, which is quite acid. If you don't have an acid-forming stomach, it means that you're not breaking food down properly. It means that, you know, everything downstream is going to be affected. And ultimately, you're going to get tired, you know, you're going to have all kinds of problems, huge health problems as a result of that. So here are my four sort of methods, or my take on four methods on how you can assess the stomach properly for acid levels. The first test is the most expensive option, but probably also the most accurate. It's called the Heidelberg Test. So here, basically on an empty tummy, usually in the morning, you've got to swallow this tiny capsule. And this tiny little capsule, it contains a radio transmitter inside it. It's an incredible high-tech little gadget. It's very small, so don't worry, you won't choke on it. It's an expensive test. It's about $350 to do the test, and it's probably not covered by your insurance company. But about 130, 140 studies say that this is the best test in terms of how accurate it is. So you drink 4 to 6 ounces of water with some baking soda in there after you've swallowed that capsule. And what the capsule does is it starts assessing what's happening in your stomach, you know, as that baking soda is going in there. And it's looking and it's giving constant readings. As long as that stays in the stomach, it will keep reading. And then, of course, you're going to pass it out and it'll be collected. And then all these readings can be done. So best test, accurate test, expensive test. The second test is a home test. It's very cheap. It's a couple of dollars. And it's a baking soda test. Well, basically, you're going to put about a quarter to a half a teaspoon of baking soda. You're going to mix that in a bit of water again. And you're going to drink that first thing in the morning on an empty stomach. And what should happen, you know, you're either going to belch or you're not going to belch. So if you belch pretty quick, and if you don't belch pretty quick, it's going to give me a lot of interesting information. Healthy people are going to belch very quick because they're going to convert that baking soda into carbon dioxide very fast. So as soon as you drink that, literally before 2 or 3 minutes, you should have a bit of a belch. Right? If you don't belch for 3 to 5 minutes, you've got low stomach acid because there's no conversion to carbon dioxide there. So that's a problem. The third test is the betaine hydrochloride test, the betaine HCl test. You're going to have a meal, just a meal on its own, containing about 6 ounces of good quality meat, some chicken, or preferably some steak, some beef. You're going to cut that up, you're going to eat that, and halfway during the meal, you're going to swallow one capsule of betaine HCl. There are many different brands that will make this. Douglas Laboratories, Thorne Research, there are several companies that make a betaine HCl. So you get a potent one and swallow one capsule in the middle of that high protein meal. Now, there are two outcomes. You're either going to feel nothing at all, or you're going to feel with, you know, as you go along your normal, you know, day after that meal, you're going to feel a bit of heaviness or burning or pain or things like that. That usually means that you've got a good level of stomach acid if you have that sensation that, oh, my gut. But if you feel nothing at all, with that, you've got a problem because you've got low stomach acid. All right, that's a third test. So no reaction is not good. A mild reaction, you know, will tell you that you've overstepped the mark. You've got too much acid going on there. You didn't need that supplement. The fourth test is the challenge test, and I like doing this one regularly on people to assess, you know, what level of hypochlorhydria they've got. So now you're going to just with breakfast one day take a betaine HCl capsule. And then with lunch that same day, you're going to take two With dinner, you're going to take 3. The following day with breakfast, you're going to take 4. So with each meal, succeeding meal, you're going to ramp up by 1 dose until you notice a heaviness behind the sternum, or a pain or heartburn or some kind of sensation. Now, I can tell you now, I've seen some people that have to get up to 10, 20 capsules per meal before they feel anything at all behind there. The older the person, the more capsules they need, generally. With each decade, people need more and more stomach support. So the fourth one will give you an idea on how flat your stomach is, you know, or how amped up it is. You shouldn't need any more than 1 capsule per meal. I think the best one I've seen, the craziest one, was about 120 capsules in a day before the person could feel anything. That's seriously bad. So there you have my take on it. They're the 4 different types of tests you can do to assess stomach acid levels to determine whether you've got hypochlorhydria or not. Thanks for checking out the video. If you're interested and you haven't got my Candida report, please click on the link in the description box. Thanks for tuning in.